Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Coffee and Conversation with Kristen. Today's topic is all about the December update, right? It's going to be about what's going on in the market. What do I see happening? All the good stuff, the nitty gritty, because I keep getting comments too from people that say, you know what, Kristen, this is just like 2008. When is this bubble going to burst? All right. So let's just really quick go back to that topic. It is not 2008 to 2010. We are not in a lending crisis. We are not inflating values artificially as was back in 2008 and 10. That was a true lending crisis. Values are up right now, pure appreciation due to supply and demand, right? We need a lot more houses on the market than we still even have. They don't really see this in all the research that we've done. We don't really see this changing much. Now, for instance, there were about 1 million housing starts in this last month. We essentially need 2 million in order to flip the switch, if you will. So what am I saying by that? I'm saying that we're still not building enough homes to meet the criteria of people who are looking to buy homes. People who are pre-approved, well-qualified to purchase homes, okay? So with that said, we are still going to see this going on in this market for a while. This is not something that's just going to stop overnight. This is the new reality we are in. Now, good news on that, appreciation is truly up by people paying more due to that supply and demand factor, all right? Now, where this is great to still be a homeowner is rates are still low, you guys. They may not be as low as they were about 5 or 6 months ago, but they're still low. And they are still relatively volatile. So you want to keep an eye on that, right? So if you have a pre-approval, make sure you're working with your lender every month for updated pay stubs and then also getting that rate check to make sure rates didn't tick up at all. Now, will they just go through the roof and skyrocket? I don't believe so. I believe next year we're going to see a couple rate hikes, and that's kind of everything we're reading and seeing in the news from CoreLogic, from a bunch of other, you know, the equity firms and mortgage firms, as well as our Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac partners, things of that nature. So though I don't really see rates going crazy, however, I do anticipate a couple rate hikes, if you will, meaning rates will go up in the next year. So plan on that. Now, with that being said, because of the appreciation up, if you are a homeowner, you have a lot of value in your home that you probably didn't have 1 to 2 years ago. Rates being low, this is still a phenomenal time to take advantage of maybe cashing out that equity to put it, pay off the consolidation, consolidate that debt. If you got yourself into some heavy credit card debt at, you know, 15 to 20%, take advantage of putting that maybe into the equity and starting over. There's nothing like sleeping at night because you don't have any debt, right? And it's not artificial equity. It's not just gonna go away in a couple of years. Your equity is going to increase. They're saying, I've seen you guys all over the board. I think it's really just a matter of where you are in the nation. They're saying anywhere from 2 to 3%, still up to 15, 16% in there. And a couple are falling in between there. So there's, you know, you can really Google any of those articles and read them and you'll probably see anything in there. I really think it's just a matter of where you're located in the nation. There are still some big cities across the country that are really red hot markets, right? So those are going to appreciate higher. There are some that have cooled down. So it's just a matter of where you're at. Overall though, they're assuming that and thinking that rates, equity are going to, appreciation are going to increase in your home. Therefore, even if you are consolidating some debt, great way to do it because you're still going to build that equity in your home just by pure appreciation. So that's great. Over this next few weeks, you really want to be cognizant because it is the holiday season. If you are buying a home right now, congratulations to you in the process. You want to just make a few reminders that the Fridays before Christmas and New Year's are considered federal holidays. That means that even if the title companies and lenders are open, they are non-funding days, meaning you can't close and fund your loan on those days. So if your closing is scheduled for either of those days, you want to work with your lender and title company, real estate agents right away, make sure you're changing that. Also, you want to be prepared because everybody's using up their vacation that's due at the end of the year. I don't care what lending institution, title company, real estate agent firm you work for, there are vacations that are taken both to celebrate the holidays with their families as well as burning up that vacation. So things do tend to slow down. Appraisals tend to get a little bit more backed up here over the next few weeks, things of that nature. So patience. Patience is really something you want to do. The other thing I'll always say is make sure if your lender or your real estate agent, anybody's asking you for documents, you get it to them right away. Time is really of the essence for us to stay on track. So little tidbit for you there. We all know inflation's up. I think it's kind of a drawn out conversation. We know it, it's here. Everything costs more. In fact, I don't know of anything. If you know something that actually costs less, I wanna know, bring them below. Besides interest rates from a couple of years ago, as far as that perk is concerned, I think pretty much everything else is up. But with that being said, we're probably going to see a continual rise on that here, which is also going to work with the markets and rates. So again, just another food for thought for why I think the rates are going to tick up. And I think anyone that you meet in our industry is well aware of that. So I don't think it's just my opinion. I think it's an average opinion over the industry. Also, rents are still on the rise. They're up 0.5% month over month. They're up about 3-4% year over year right now. And again, depending on where you live, some areas much higher, some areas may not have too much of a change. However, that's just another reason. And you know, I've discussed the three P's: patience, persistence, positivity. If you are renting and your rent is continually going up, rates are still really low, you can get into a home with very little down payment, talk to a lender, get pre-approved, and get ready. Because if you can still buy a house next year or even in the beginning of next year, you're really going to be winning with a low rate and you're going to be getting that money back, if you will, that you put down in the course of appreciation, most likely over the next few years. So really great opportunity for you there. That's just another reason why I think it's really a great time to get back into the market if you have left the market or if you're just kind of thinking about buying a home. Also, just with everything, lending as well as everyone, we are going to be just, you know, taking time for our families and such. However, our team has a plan in place to still make sure you're getting pre-approved over this holiday season. If you need to be and you are looking at a home, one comes on the market, you absolutely need it, give us a call. We are here for you, okay? So that's kind of the December going into early next year. We'll get you an update after the first of the year again on where the market sits, but I just wanted to touch base with you on what we're seeing right now. Hope you guys are all doing really well here in Wisconsin. We're having our first, I guess, real big snowstorm, if you will. We are writing pre-approvals all weekend long, so if you need us, reach out. As always, if you have any questions on any of this content, drop your comments below, give us a call, happy to talk more with you about it. We're licensed throughout the entire Midwest and Florida. So if now you're thinking about that vacation home in Florida, we would love to help you do that. Thank you so much. Hope you're having a great day. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.